How do you turn nothing into something? Here's how you start. There's three steps to it. Number one, imagination. So imagination starts to change everything. Now, imagination is not tangible, but it is almost real. But it's hard to say that imagination is nothing. But it's nothing in terms of tangible. It's not tangible yet. And you always have to say yet. Imagination is not tangible yet. But it is the beginning of turning nothing into something. It's the beginning of turning nothing into reality. Imagination. Imagination is the ability to see things that don't yet exist. Imagination is real in the sense that it affects. It'll affect your behavior, it'll affect your enthusiasm, it'll affect your emotions. It's real in that sense, but it's not real in the tangible sense. But to turn nothing into something, you start with imagination. Next is faith. To believe that what you imagine is possible. How would we start to strengthen our belief in that what we imagine is possible to turn it into reality? And there's two or three ways. One is to believe your own testimony. If you've done it before, why couldn't you do it again? If you've done it once, couldn't you do it the second time? Why not believe in your own testimonial? If I did it before, I can do it again. I was rich by age 31 and broke by age 33. But now my question was, could I do it again? And the answer was, yes, of course. You know, I lost the money, but I didn't lose the skills. And that's what's important about personal development. You can lose the money, but not the skills. So who cares about the money? Hey, once you've got the skills, you own the skills. It's like sales. A skill is more valuable than a sale. Sometimes a salesperson says, I need a sale. I said, no, you need a skill. Sales are temporary. Skills are permanent. So we start with imagination, which is almost real. I mean, it's not real yet. It's not tangible yet, but it's almost real. Now we move to faith to believe that what we imagine is possible. So we study our own testimony. If we've done it before, we can do it again. Here's what else we study. Other testimonials of somebody who did it. Somebody that built a hotel said, yes, I started with some plans and finally believed it was possible, and here it is. Say, well, if it's possible for one, it's possible for another. In fact, sometimes when we hear the testimonial, here's how they finish. If I can do it, you can do it. See, that's a classic testimonial that gives us now what we call faith. And one of the ancient wise writers said, faith is generated by what we hear. The vocabulary of what we hear, the vocabulary of what we read, that generates faith to believe that it's possible. Now, faith is not reality. You can't say faith is nothing. Because it affects. It's like radiation. To us, it's nothing because it can't be seen. But radiation is so powerful, it can kill you. You can't see it, but it has an incredible effect. And that's true of faith. Faith can't be seen with the natural eye. It can't be seen, but it has an incredible effect on your attitude, on your behavior, on your disciplines, on your work for the day, and all the rest. So faith is tangible in that sense, that it affects the emotions, it affects the drive. But we still don't have a hotel. Even though the imagination is very powerful, and even though faith is very real, we still don't have a hotel. Because faith is not a hotel. Now, it's almost. It is so close. Here's what one writer described faith. Faith is a substance of hope. It's not a substance like a brick being a piece of the hotel. But it's almost. It's so close, it's substance. The writer also said it's so close, it's evidence. Now, not evidence you can see, but tangible evidence that's just as real as all of our human experiences that can't be touched, can't be seen. It's called the unseen magic. Language is the unseen magic. It can't be seen. The words can't be seen as they're transmitted from the speaker to the one who listens, but it can have a profound effect. That means it's more than nothing. But to create something out of nothing, we start with imagination, then we move to faith, which believes it's possible, which is almost real. I built my first home for my family in Idaho many, many years ago. And before I started this home to construct it, I used to take my friends out to the vacant property. And I would take them on a tour through this house. Do you believe that? I would say this is the living room. It's got a fireplace here. It's brick. And then come around here into the family room. Another fireplace, see-through. On this side it's stone, on this side it's brick. I would walk them through the three-car garage. Then I'd say, go, now we're going to take a tour into the kitchen. Here's the view outside the kitchen. They'd look through the window at the view. I could describe it to the detail. I could describe this whole house in detail. I described it so well one day, one of my friends bumped his shoulder on the fireplace. Left a little bruise there. Isn't that true, though? Faith and imagination is almost. It's called evidence and substance. Now, it's still not tangible, but it's not far from tangible. But now here's what we do with faith and imagination. We deposit it in disciplines and activity. Because faith without the activity serves no useful purpose. Imagination without the activity to translate it into reality serves no purpose. But wisdom and faith deposited in activity creates reality. The reality of a career, the reality of a hotel that wasn't there. And the question goes like this: when should you start building the hotel that you've imagined and now believe that it's possible? When should you start? And here's the answer: as soon as you have it finished. You just got to remember that. You wouldn't start building a hotel unless you had it finished. Because if you start building something, somebody says, what's this going to look like? You say, I have no idea. See, they'd take you away to a safe place. No, the reason you start is because it's finished. So here's what we teach in time management. Don't start the day until you have it finished. You've got it laid out. Plenty of room for improvising, plenty of room for spontaneity, but you finish the day and then you start the day. You finish the week, then you start the week. But you shouldn't start building the hotel until you have it finished. Is it possible to finish it before you start? And the answer is yes. It would be foolish to start unless you had it finished. Unique things to remember. Now, here's what now turns wisdom and faith into reality, and that's activity, muscle. The labor, the work.